Edgar.
Progress that has been made towards and ripping off the old road which was there, which caused a lot of potholes, and it has not made so much progress because I think we've only funded them about 233 million out of what we owe, 274. We actually owe about 41 million quarter. The contractors requested for a bit of support at the moment that should enable him to get an asphalt plant to the site. They've made an agreement with China here. When we saw that there was not so much progress, we asked them to get in touch with another contractor who had all the equipment and to help boost the capacity. So they signed an MOU with China here. They're now going to make the project together with China here. And so they have agreed that they bring an asphalt plant. They've made a request for some money. And about 3-4 days ago, we made available a 4 million quarter to enable them to move an asphalt plant so that they can finish the 8 kilometers on the Kambo site, and then now they can begin to focus on this one going forward. There's been slow progress on this project, Your Excellence. I think the contributing factor has been finances, so it's really at the snail's pace, bit by bit. If we find some money, and you know, Your Excellence, pushing a lot of money, we can make available a bit more money, and with the process provision and the collaboration with China here, we believe that we can make progress. People in the area really want to see this road completed and done, the shortcuts in Ndola headquarters. Our MPs have been on our necks every day in offices trying to make sure that this is done. So this is where we have, we all put one to them, but we are at 7% collaboration. So we wish you to have a feel on the image of the site that people are complaining about.
Some people
have
been saying this is a potential project which can self-maintain. This is one of the few traffic between Congo, Mufulira, and Ndola, because of the tunnel.
Your Excellency, in fact, we have a proposal by a company, a logistics company, owned by some Chinese on the Congolese side. I think they are passing their trucks here, so it's their interest that they see that the road is done. They have pushed in a proposal, except they want it from Sakania border post. In fact, they want, the proposal includes improvement of the entire Sakania border post to a very big border post, and then join this road all the way to Ndola. So there will still be a portion that we'll have to work on. So that proposal we sent to the Minister of Commerce to have it studied, because it includes border facilities, improving them, increasing car parks. The envisage increased traffic from Congo because of so many mining activities happening there. So there is a proposal, in fact, Your Excellency, and it is a thought that we are entertaining together with the Minister of Commerce.
For them being, why don't you focus on this part of the road, which will dovetail into the integrated road network?
Yes, we stand guided, Your Excellence. That's our wish.
As we come here, if you're talking to these guys, want to come and improve the road, control in it and everything. The focus could be on which part of the road to make it possible to conclude with the economy. That's come on the fit in there.
Yes, sir, exactly. And those PPP partners actually have money ready available. They said if you allow us, we can even bring the money to Zambia right now. You know, it's Minister of Commerce is still studying the matter because of the border facilities. I understand.
Now that they're going for campaigns, they said, you vote, they're giving the facility that side, they didn't really vote. And the rest part of the opposition comes here and tells them, look, you said your vote, you voted for us, and hence you give them talk about it. One of our critics is that we want to typically distribute development.
Let's go.